Do you know what an artist and a sniper have in common? Details. Like when a touch of color is out of place. When a shadow does not match with its surroundings. Or when a shape is not where it is supposed to be. The only difference is the stakes. Mine are higher.
Hello. Good day. Lucas should say something.
Am I
slide?
Yeah. Am I supposed to?
Fuck. I mean, goddamn. Yes. So, what is this?
Producer then. So we've got Phila and some other stuff.
Other stuff, nice.
Yeah, man.
No, it's gonna be a great game.
It is. Starting on Villa, I'm sure it'll be a very entertaining. It's a very entertaining map.
What if it's not?
Well,
that'd be
awesome.
Unlucky.
It would be.
Fucks you guys watching. Trying to make it. There we go. Right, what are we expecting?
I'm expecting a close game. I'm not sure who's gonna win this one.
First off, who is playing?
It's Elbaro versus Woof, who are from K9.
Do you know anyone from either of those people?
Not really, to be honest. I've played a little bit with DJ. I'm not sure if he was playing in this game, but he's a pretty good player. I know I've played against Elbaro. They're pretty good. My team has beat them. Their team's beat us. It's been fairly even.
So it's
I'm expecting a close game, for sure.
There's going to be some inside rivalry with you. You're not going to want him to win. I see how it is.
No, I wouldn't say so. I have no bias here.
Oh, that's the word, bias. Right, you've got the word. Cool. Anyway.
We also have Border, and our finale will be Cafe if needed. I like all of those maps to watch, at least. They're all very entertaining maps to watch. playing, not so much, but to watch, definitely very entertaining. And I think it'll be a lot of fun for these two teams. I think expect a lot of roaming, especially from Wolf. They like to get in your face a lot. Now, but I expect very, very default stuff from them. Their style is quite default. They like to keep it simple, really. Don't like to overcomplicate things, get too aggressive or anything like that.
Wondering what ops they're going to pick, wondering if they're going to have any strats, whether they're going to wing it.
Yeah, who knows? I suppose we've got to go into the game to find that out.
Well, I'm ready to go in whenever.
Yeah, I'm ready as well. Just need our producer to send us in. Anytime now.
Good day.
And there we go.
Elbro, right.
That's just them shortening their uni's name from Loughborough. So it's quite a mouthful.
So Loughborough v Chai ish.
That looks like Tevs needs saving already. Yeah, I think he already wants to get out of this game.
Well, let's hope it's a quick one, but I have a score thing, it won't be.
Guess I just don't want to deal with someone calling them up. I'm pretty sure we've seen that Nook ban quite a few times from Marlboro. Might see a Valk ban, maybe a Mirror ban. Marlboro, most likely. I don't know what to expect from Wolf, though, on defense. And I'm guessing there's some sort of issue. No? Okay, we're good. Zabi, not what I was expecting. It's certainly quite unusual, really. Not the kind of ban I was expecting on this map. She's okay, but I mean,
definitely not the usual Jackal Thatcher. There's a Valkyrie. Right. That's pretty normal.
Yeah, there's the part.
That's pretty usual, to be fair. Right, the Doki and the Valkyrie we could expect. The Nook and his army, though, that's a bit different from usual.
Yeah.
See, if I do like a bit of a zombie on this map, can't I?
She is good on this map, though. Picked up the Yug immediately. She's very meta at the moment. I've been enjoying playing her recently. Yeah, the W7M. They did just win the most recent major, so.
Well, they did, yeah. Well, that's very upsetting. They did knock out G2 pretty quick, can't they?
No, they didn't.
They're not?
No.
Oh, I thought they got like knocked out. Like.
No, the G2 did get knocked out. They got knocked out in the first round of the playoffs, but they had to play plenty of games before then.
Wow. Look at that. I don't know anything because I didn't follow them.
Yeah, they got knocked out by Liquid, who they destroyed in the stage before. It was really unfortunate.
I used to like Liquid. I used to like watch them back in the day.
Yeah, Liquid just got to the finals, choke another one. That's all they did.
Maybe they need to get better.
And if you look here, you can see an earthquake happening on the screen.
I'm seeing an earthquake. But I think everyone else is fine.
Yes, I hope so. I hope this isn't what the stream is saying.
But it's all okay. Right, well. Many rotates being made. Attacker's objective is very nice. Oh, of course the Jackal. Fair enough. If he's not banned, might as well use him. Very rare occurrence.
He's good to clear out any potential roaming zone. I mean, as I said before, I predict that Kanan will have a lot of roaming zone. You can already see the Oryx picked up. You pick up Oryx if you want to roam, not to play on zone. I expect the other two probably playing their site because they're not very quick operators, but they could be seen roaming as well, potentially.
Well, but they knew they're
Kanan already trying to get into their face. Yeah.
That's
Yana doesn't want to have to deal with any of that. I haven't seen Blaz play before, though. He was, he's new to me. So I don't know what to expect from him, but Bob, we've seen lots of Bob, we've seen lots of Funk. Funk, very good player, Bob. He has his moments.
Oh, well, I've played against Bob a while ago. He was very good against me. He just had, used to have a thing against me. Don't know why, but we move.
He must have. He must have just been jealous of your good looks.
Yeah, I am. Exactly. Yeah, exactly. Well, they've definitely got operators to stop a rush, I'll tell you that. They got.
I don't think they were anticipating a rush, though.
Oh.
Good shots on the clone. Nice.
Didn't give away too much. He's still behind the barricade.
It's an interesting way of using game. Whiffing on the camera, not what you want to see. They have the control they were looking for. Do they have a hard breacher? They do. Hard breach, yes. That's going to give them a lot of control. We'll see. It's difficult to capitalize on that control, though, I've found.
Oh, they can get some good angles on them, though, if they don't whiff it.
Giannis died. Not sure from where.
I think it was from
I think it was main stairs.
Oh, yeah.
No, I'm not 100%. Oh, that's a very blind Oryx. But not doing anything, I think. Yeah, she was behind bar, I think. No, she's steady. So yeah, where W main stairs.
Oh, they know he's on that side. Oh, but he's not. He could get the flank of a sentry here. Or not. Never mind. Right. Wow.
Oh, Toad just got shot down. That man, really. Nothing to do. That's what I mean. Even if you get that full breach, it's difficult to really get anything done with it.
Good luck, have fun, they're saying in chat now. They are putting their cocky chats.
Yeah, I believe last time we saw Wolf play, they were not very happy about that, losing that game.
That Warden's definitely there to count the Ying that they played
last
round.
Yeah, he's also mentioned, so curious to see if Blaze brings it up. No,
well, maybe not.
He's given the Ash. He might pick until the Ying still, though, so we'll see.
Mm.
That Warden isn't changing, though.
Now, Warden can be really good in some instances, but
I think, oftentimes when I see a Warden in my rank games, even when there's a Ying on board, he won't do anything, he's just roaming off site.
Yeah,
it's very
they
sad.
Do that.
And
some
then
people
everyone
roaming,
on site,
really.
Yeah, and then everyone on site would die to a Ying, and you're like, oh, exactly. Warden would have been very helpful. Oh, we have a Warden. Oh,
yeah, well, Warden would love to be Warden somewhere else other than where they need to be a Warden. Where the smoke isn't, they are. So
exactly.
But you know. That's what puts the good from the bad.
So what I just hit doing my rank games is I just ban Warden, so I don't have to deal with that.
There we go. I didn't even know that was a little drone hole there. 5 seconds to go. Nice bit of settings.
Yeah, gotta love some settings.
Love it. Right, well there you go. If you ever need to adjust your settings, use those.
Yeah, exactly.
Look, they're doing a lot of peaks. It's basically coming really quick, but they're not. And they're from the other side as well.
I don't think they're expecting them to become quick. I think they're just quick players. Because I'm on the type of team that go quick.
Don't know what that glib did to that guy, but okay.
No, he wanted to gun. He needed the space. It's a very claustrophobic kind of guy.
Well, from that drone, they probably now know they're all in bedroom, bathroom area. I hope they get pre-fire going off. Suiciding his drone.
Well, they know exactly where the Warden is, and they're gonna have to try and frag him to clear him out or just shoot him. Good old fashioned
nice
way of dealing with someone.
Very nice feet hold, but not really useful because no one can see him.
Yeah, exactly.
I like the spirit. I thought we'd throw a lot of shade. Nice nade, but nothing that. From that position, Ion is pretty useless because you can't really use your drone at any point.
Yeah, it's difficult to rotate from there as well.
And you can't really chuck a nade without them having full view. To be fair. Oh, very nice kill.
Right, good entry from the line. He killed the Astra player. That's a lot of control as well. Still needs to deal with the master person. That's a very nice kill from She Left Me. He's in a good position now as well.
What a name.
Good,
hope he's okay.
Good restraint from the line there. That was an important kill from the Yana. Big kill from Bob. They must know where Oryx is.
Oh,
that was a very nice entry from Bob. Clean shooting.
Yeah.
So this can be a quick tech pause just to get a player back in. We'll be back with you in a second.
attackers need to locate and defuse as many bombs as they can.
Wall secured!
Right, okay, they're in. You're muted.
Yeah, high production quality over here, that was. So yeah, just a slight technical difficulty, just need to get one of the players back in. I should really though. Back to the same site though.
So we got ourselves an iron again, a sledge again, I'm assuming for those nays. We got a lion, because he did well in that last time. Probably just wants the LMG, to be honest. A little bit of smoke, a time.
Yeah, just doing the same clear.
Got a whammy just for them nades. Good old counters.
Yeah, the whammy though, your nades didn't find too much impact really. It was a shooting from Bob that found the impact.
That is true. Can't beat pure gun skill in the end. All have black ice, as just noticed, but... Magnet activated. Oh, and you can see his head. Oh, that's a lucky runaway.
See, you have to wonder if he could hit that shot, but the smoke hit it for him anyway. So good job from the smoke. Good entry kill. Not the person you expect to find the entry kill, but makes sense with how we saw this smoke player playing last time on the warden. He's playing in an aggressive position, and he's clearly an aggressive player. So definitely a very strong master setup. Brave of them to go here again. Yeah, oh, look, Sledge is trying to find space because he knows he can't push into that. That setup's just too strong.
Oh,
he's
going to
go for
nades.
Just a foot yard. This looks like this is going to be perfect.
Oh, he's amazing.
And if
he
threw it in a different place, he could have got a double kill with that one nade. Like, that would have been nasty.
That is amazing. Oh, my
what
god.
What a shot from Tebs. Oh,
Jesus.
My god.
That makes me happy.
Yeah.
Two spicy kills.
The game that K9 or Wiff lost. Tebs wasn't there. I mean, you can see why they were missing him. What a shot. Looking forward to seeing this replay. You can tell that he's got some high refresh right here.
He's just
don't
better.
Hit about 60.
Nice. But that was a spicy nade. Can't lie. That makes me happy to see. That's proper siege techniques coming out. I do like my
excellent
nade.
Yeah. Excellent round from Wiff. They take the lead 2-1. It is a defender sided map most of the time, at least at this level. And in 3v3, I'd certainly expect it to be. And with the way that Elboro are attacking it, it's very difficult. I think they're going to struggle to get any attacking rounds on the board with this kind of style on this kind of map against this kind of team. It just doesn't seem to be working very well. It's so one dimensional. They're able to just sit in their spots, and their spots are strong.
1D, one direction.
Yeah, they need to try and push the people out of their spots, make them uncomfortable, because the way they're pushing them, they are perfectly happy to just sit where they are, take the gunfights, because they're taking them on their terms, not on Elboro's terms.
I'm liking that setup, it means they're going to get aggressive on that study door.
It's a default setup. It's a very default setup.
Oh, fair enough. Fair enough.
Nothing unusual.
I'm just scared, obviously.
Does Blaz know the shield? I don't think he knows the shield. You need to practice that one, that's difficult to understand how to place. It took me a while to figure it out.
It's good for his army for that route, that setup. You can put it in all different places, it blocks so many lines. But as long as you don't block your own line site.
Yeah, Wooden doesn't know how to do the shield, so he's picking main side. That's still a good shield, though.
There is a good nade you can do from that where one of them are now. We can throw it all the way to the back. As long as you just move that urn that's in the way, then it gets quite a few kills.
That's what you just said, did that make sense?
I don't know, I explained it. That urn where, who was it? Who was on the top of there? It was Ace. Yeah, if Ace had a nade, it can chuck it diagonally onto the warden.
Ah, I see,
it goes
I see.
All the way through the door, mounts off that wall.
Well, very, that's pretty
common thing.
Very nice take. Or you could just go to the study window.
True, but then they can shoot back.
Not if you go prone, or if not if you jiggle it.
But I'm not that good. Gotta rep the nades. Repping the nades.
This is a lot of control for Yana. She knows half of the map is clear.
Well, they've left it all open.
I mean, I think Oba are quite happy to be on the attack side now. Don't actually quite realise. Or on the defense now. Very nice entry from Tevs.
Cheers.
He found the space. Warden didn't know where him. Tev looks like he's a league above these players. A good close from Zonkin.
Very nice. Jackal is a powerful person. If you needed to be.
Yeah, he is. It's just I know as a defender you hate it. Just they constantly knowing where you are. Yeah, it looks like we'll probably be taking this one. I haven't really seen anything from Elbow that would make me think otherwise. Especially with them winning that first round on attack so convincingly. It's going to make things very difficult for our boy.
Sadly, the warden I think hasn't been able to do much recently. They haven't got any smokes down.
No, I think he's just playing him for the gun. I think that's the purpose.
Then you'd rather pick something like Valkyrie though. I mean, I guess you got the 1.5.
Yeah, you've got the 1.5, that's the idea.
But yeah, and after that, they got a bit of a P juice, that's fair enough.
Yeah, that's because you don't get the headshots, so that's why.
That is true, that is true.
Well, it's pretty picky guns on the hour to get headshots. Oh, yeah, big Alder fan, then. That hits like a shark.
Which gun?
Alder, my show's LMG.
Oh, yeah! That is a very good gun. And you can spray it at things continuously as well.
Exactly. What LMG nerf, am I right? Yeah, the fact that they played less is a nice spot. When I play them personally, at least on console, I haven't noticed it too much. Even on PC, I've noticed it too much.
Yeah.
I think they're still nice to use. I think people just think that they're bad, so they don't use them. So we could see a return of the LMG mount at some point, potentially.
Yeah, well, meta's moving all the time with the updates.
Yeah, exactly. I think the meta would evolve even without these updates, because if you look at a game like CSGO, there is very few changes, but the meta is constantly evolving.
That is true. Yeah, it's very, very interesting how they change that much. I remember what Siege used to be, everyone used to be pretty bad, and now like the worst players are still like really good, like from back then. We're all learning. Exploring new angles.
So many unique things you can find in this game, it's never going to end.
I still think now people have found which are there.
Yeah, exactly.
So many angles, so many cool positions. Awesome.
They're starting to professional to the site now, though. Oh, whiff.
They are taking a bit of time.
I have to control they won. I imagine that Elbow was set up for a master take, because that's what they did. But Wolf have no interest in that kind of take. They want to take from study side. It's a viable take, but you need to get an entry kill to be able to start getting the space you need. And they haven't been given it just yet. I gotta think the Blast needed to get that kill clean. Because this is a big damn fight, he wants to be a peak. It's just so rough. Excellent entry from Tevs. They have sight. They had half sight. That's what you mean by kill. Okay, kill, you get a lot of space.
Good job.
Well, yeah, last game. Game set. First game over. GG's, boys. Okay. Very well played, Jordan. That was a very convincing one. Not much to say about. Elbow, they looked completely out of depth there. Tevs just walked all over them. He seemed like he was out of their league. And then the rest of his team, they were just there to carry it. They were just there carrying their weight, really.
And we're going into border.
I don't think we're going into it straight away.
Oh, sure. In a minute, we will be going into border.
I mean, it would be nice if our producer told us what's happening.
Yeah. So.
Okay. Yeah. What are your thoughts on that game?
I mean, I like it. There's some good shots, some spicy shots, can't I? I do like my spicy shots. some nicely done nades. That takes droney skill, even though they did lose that round. But those nice nades from the floor, that's just sticking with me. Otherwise, yeah, I'm liking it. They got some pretty good basic setups.
You have to expect that after watching that Wolf will be able to close this out. Very convincing, really. I mean, Elbow need to show a different side to themselves here if they want to come out on top.
I'm sure they will. Is this their map pick next?
Truthfully, I don't know.
Yeah, well, if it is, I'm sure they'll have some ideas for this one. Otherwise, they're going to need it.
Yeah, to border we go, I believe.
Here we go. Well, they've got a Ying ban, a Dokubi ban. It's very good entries.
Yeah, Ying ban makes sense because they don't want to deal with that anymore.
Looks like they just want to get off the Warden there. Don't need it anymore. They're going to get rid of Ying. Oh, there's Warden.
Yeah. That's an odd ban with Ying being banned. I think they just saw that Blaz like playing it. So they're target banning that.
Yeah.
I don't understand the Ying ban so much from Elbow because from the previous map, Wolf weren't playing it at all. They banned his army again. I obviously think that's a very powerful operator. And she is. I mean, I can't imagine that she's got the most powerful setups on this map, especially.
Yeah, I don't like his army. Well,
they've had a substitute though. Blaz has been replaced by DJ5. This is a very interesting development. That could provide them with the extra dimension they need.
Well, it is their not their Mac pick, so we're thinking that maybe they'll have some tricks up their sleeve. Even if they did swap out.
Looking forward to this now that DJ subbed in. This might be an interesting game. Oh, he's not got his cap can. I can tell you from experience that DJ's cap can is pretty nasty. I've been railed more than once by that.
What, especially from DJ? Or just
yeah, his cap can. Yeah, his cap can is very good.
He knows his way. I've been using cap can recently. He's great. You just gotta put it the opposite side from where you would be.
Oh, I didn't get killed by the Kalkan traps. No one on my team got killed by the Kalkan traps. Wow. Yeah, he's just a gunner with him.
Ah, right, okay.
You give him a VSN and he pops heads.
Oh, okay, I'm liking that.
The thing about that single Kalkan trap there is that most people don't realize there's a doorway in the hallway. Because why would there be a doorway in a hallway? So they just walk into it and think they're in the hallway.
He's spreading an L bomb. Very nice. Oh, we got the Monty running in, we got a Gridlock, they're definitely going for a plot. If I can see that anyway. Gridlock can stop their rotations. Glad's just gonna pick up all the kills. Like you can imagine. Sadly about the Solace, unless they're on cameras, they won't really be able to see much with these operators.
Vital kill for Kate Elbow to get very, very important. With that should be the round, really, you have to imagine. That's their strategy going. The last one alive has no HP left. It might be Tebs, but he doesn't have any HP to work with anymore. They know exactly where he is. Yes, that was a very nice attempt from K9, but very well played. Lovely shot down. TJ showing his belly already. He's got double kill. The first two kills of the game. I told you to watch out for him. It's not the Captain Champs you need to worry about with him.
Gun.
Yeah, he's a gunner.
Wow.
I don't seem to be happy about that. That's C4. A beautiful round from DJ. I told you to keep an eye on him.
Got five health. Man. 5 health and dream. I believe. Not much belief, but I do believe. Careful, run out of team. Oh.
Active. They know exactly where the fuse is. I mean, if Solace probably would have been able to deny the world. No, actually, Solace couldn't have denied the bomb.
Oh, DJ down.
I imagine he was just going for an aggressive play to try and get the ace or a corner of the ace.
Laps can't like it.
I think that's a play on his name.
Yeah. I thought I picked that up pretty quick. What are the Langer they have there? Oh, okay.
Interesting.
Ready for the car?
Very diligent of it. Maybe Captain Traps, but I'm willing to bet that he will die to a Captain Trap regardless of the fight he's shaking. Okay, there's still one more trap he could walk into in that area. I really hope he walks into it. He's checking so carefully.
He's checking, yeah. But right now, you don't want to get caught. One cap can ruin his whole day.
He's walking to it.
Go.
I don't think he's going to walk. Yeah, he did. DJ from the grave.
Even
avenges
from the
himself. He was being so diligent that you knew he was going to die to that cap can trap.
Right, what we got here? We got a Jackal Sledge. Smoking aboard, Malusi slammed out. Oh, switch to Alibi.
I think they're just picking for guns on defense. And on attack, to be honest. Defense. I don't think they're going to go for any like strategies again. I think they're just going to go for kills like they were going on the previous map, because that was what was working for them. They weren't going for any like big strategies, they were just killing.
Yeah, well, they did a good attempt on the plant on the attack team. They just the attackers final.
They got shot down. It was like nice from DJ. The Solis couldn't even shot that down unless she was downstairs. Because if she tried to do it from side, she would be shooting the shield on Monty's back.
Okay.
One of the big and nice things about having the Monty planning then. So really, it was all down to teachers. He thought there was no other way to start that plan. Dead, I believe that is. Yeah. Only one drone left, well, four drones left. Not ideal, but we'll see how much training they need to do.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds left. Attackers
are dead. All four five. But alarms, I gotta figure out where they are. They've got alarms everywhere.
He's still humble enough to break the castle, but use the worst gun in the game. Some say, anyway. What are your thoughts on the EMP, Andrew?
Honestly, I quite like it.
Yeah, it's quite enjoyable, but that's because it's just low recoil.
It's a very
and
good.
It's got 1.5. You've disgusted me.
Honestly, I'm horrible. I'm a nade and spawn peak user. I'm the scum of siege.
I think too highly of myself to be able to stoop so low as this one peak.
It does more than get killed. It
really does. I just don't think it's one peak, so I don't swamp peak.
Oh, I like that. If the shotgun
can
reach.
Yeah, first shotgun. Terrible shotgun. I'd love to see if it can reach. Oh, I think she made it. He's hit after the shotgun. And after all of that, he found the door. Oh, might have to use that angle on my rank games. That's a pretty nice angle.
Yeah, that's a really nice angle. I'm liking that. That's big. Oh, you learn something every day.
Yeah, yes, please.
Every day is a school day, as they say.
Oh, you learn something here every day, I believe is the saying.
Look at that. Oh, well, they know they're on that side.
Yeah. Maybe hold upstairs. They're pushing you straight into the hold, which is interesting. But. Last time, I'm sure they can. I don't think they can get a rehost with that. He's just gonna have to return and they're just unlucky. Well, I mean, nice entry kill from them. They just kicked them out of the game, I guess. Not what you want to see there.
I kind of think what the best operator would be for that angle they've made there. I mean, there is
I
the.
I mean, it doesn't matter as long as you can hear your shots.
That's true.
So, anyone? Works. Yeah, it looks like they are getting ready to rotate out. They're just seeing if they can catch anyone before they leave. A bit greedy, but... Yeah, I think I'll back up now.
Kind of baited out both of them. Oh, and they've seen a drop.
Yeah, they know what's happening now.
They're able to stick the plant.
Yeah, there's no time left, though. Yeah, this has got to be a elbow round, though. There isn't any time for an execute of any kind. We don't have the time to kill all three of these defenders. 20 seconds remaining. Jackal's going through. He wasn't ready for the second villain. There's no time left.
10 seconds left.
It was a nice attempt from Tevz, just bopes on the floor so he wasn't able to hit the headshot.
I have belief.
I'm just gonna go to a quick tech pause to get this player back in. And we're back. Yep, just a short take pause to get the player back again. So it should be ready to go. Capcom back or back for DJ. I'm sure he'll be very thrilled to have that back.
Attackers need to locate as many bombs as they can.
I really enjoy Bartham as a site. I just think that approach is going in third, but I mean, they've won the previous two sites, so I think they're pretty happy. This is putting Elbow in an excellent position to 3-0 and then win this and close this map out quickly.
It's very good since there's only like one like direction you really have to face. That main window that you can worry about, but otherwise they're all going to mainly push from main square and
Yeah. And I mean, I'd just like to quickly remind anyone watching that the new Operation Red Factor is being released, or well, the teaser, like the information about it is being released on Sunday at 7:30 British time. 7:30 yeah. Marked out on Sunday.
May 14th.
Yeah, exactly.
Very excited. Are you going to be watching?
Definitely. I'll have finished work by then. I'm going to be ready. What are you excited for the next season? I have to say, I'm looking forward to the Contra that we were. Because Cosplay is a terrible map.
No, I don't like Contra. I'm liking I don't know if they're doing. Yeah, they're doing the shield rework. I don't know if they're going to be doing that in this season or the one after.
I don't know. We'll have to wait until the reveal. Right,
I'm very
on
scared.
Sunday.
I'm very scared. Very interested at the same time.
Yeah, so am I. Yeah. I mean, also interestingly enough, for the high-level esports competitions, I've heard from the esports director at Ubisoft that there's going to be a lot of changes to the map pool over the summer in the 4-month off season, because there's a 4-month off season until the next stage begins.
Do you know any interesting factoids about those maps?
I don't know what's going to change, but my prediction is that Consular will be added.
Oh dear.
Based on the timing. Well, it's going to be the reworked Consular, so it'll be interesting to see. I expect it'll be a good map. I would personally love to see Camelot added, because I think it's a wonderful map, but I think it's too late for that, unfortunately.
Well, I'm excited for five new operator. I assume you have an opinion for this.
They might go back to a 7-map pool, but I don't think they'll do that. I think I don't know what else. It's a 9-map pool. For esports, but that's a lot of damage onto DJ. Is that damage just nearly from side? They're not pushing upstairs. They're not pushing into the hold. But this actually looks pretty decent from KNOT
so
far.
Given them the whole.
Yeah, they're not pushing it into the setup. They're doing their own thing, which I like. They're setting the tempo, which is what they need to do, but this should be a freebie for Kane, DJ here.
Looking the wrong way right now.
Very nice from Tevs. Tevs said freebie, not today. It doesn't really fancy what it is, just a couple of jumps again. Prompting a rough position here now, yeah. Like, they know he's upstairs as well. This is a lost round for them. I guess you can see why they didn't like this site and know why they were in it third. That was a nice
execution.
Very convincing as well.
They really were hovering above.
Yeah. See, I like that because they chose their position. They didn't push into the setup. That's so important on the attacking side. You need to set the tempo by not pushing straight into the setup. You need to attack somewhere else that you want to do.
Gotta pick your own path, guys.
Exactly.
It's a way of life.
That's why drones are so important. You need to figure out how they're holding it and avoid it, ideally. Unless you have a good counter for their setup specifically.
I'm putting caps, don't red ping, so they don't know your plans.
So, for example, if you see that they're holding a small area, just bring a ying. If you want to push into it, if it doesn't want to push away. If you don't want to bring a ying or something like that, just counter it.
One thing about ying and border, he's not very good. There's a lot of places to hide behind the border. There's always a wall.
No, it's not relevant
area
for this big thing to expect.
This is true.
Just more generally speaking.
Yeah, in general. This isn't the greatest ying, because especially if you're in the armory.
I disagree. Ying is very good. Yeah, Ying is very powerful on all maps. Like, there's a very famous Pro League clip of, I believe it's a player called Hungry. This was on Penta Esports, like 2018 or 19. And he walked, I believe it was Aztec Civilization as well. He walked into the army door corner and got an ace in about 10 seconds.
Right, well.
Yeah, so I would say this is actually a very good Ying.
Maybe he's just better.
Maybe. He's currently on Wild. And everyone still knows him for his Ying.
What is Wild?
That's the name of the esports team he's a part of. They currently play a game in Z, I do believe, against Eminem.
Oh.
That game may have already happened now, I'm not sure.
So he technically downgraded, because Penta now are G2 and they're doing
pretty
well.
He joined Penta after they were G2, and at that point they weren't a very good team, truthfully. I would say they're about the same level team as he is on now.
I've just never seen them, I've never heard of that one before.
Wild, yeah, they're very new.
Yeah.
They only joined a couple of months ago. They almost qualified for the major, but they weren't quite able to make it, I do believe.
Well, right here we got a nice little peek. He's looking for the slap of the deployable.
It's quite nice show for this breach.
Remember back in the days, deployable didn't
happen. Oh yeah, that was not a great smoke kind of stuff. That was a bit of a waste of spirit.
They're making their way to site, slowly but surely.
I was going to say, not to potentially be a close map, I'd say I'm still playing favoured here.
Trying to get some lucky sprays for the wall. See that?
Yeah, I mean, you can't get a wallbang if you don't shoot through the wall.
That's very true. In a situation like a 3v3, it's really good to get any free kills you can get.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, that's the same in any situation. An entry kill is always good. Very powerful, very good at setting the tempo on attack as well. Or for any side, for that matter. Hey guys, that shield is very powerful. It's experimental boxing again. He falls down. He shouldn't have peaked at all. He's just limping there, nice pressure. But he peaked, and that was the downfall, unfortunately, for his team. Oh, that was not great for his long game. That was a bit of a whiff.
He has quicker reaction time.
That was a nice shot, DJ.
Oh, that's a lot of
time. That was very clean from DJ. Very nice shooting. Clean shots all around it. Excellent position to close out this map now. Just a question of whether or not they can repeat that site, because it's a very difficult site to attack.
Who won the first map? Was it Woof?
Yeah, it was.
So it looks like we might be going to a map 3.
It certainly looks like it.
Well, they've got to close it on the next one then, if they don't
My
get
third
this.
Map is Cafe.
Pull back to
I love Cafe. I really enjoy Cafe at the moment.
You like it? Oh, I'm not a fan, can't lie. You and me, a very different playstyle.
Well, I've been winning them a lot recently.
That's true.
So that's
why
I like
your recent ranks.
Yeah, my ranked experience at Cafe has went well, where's it recently?
I've been lots of Coastline and... Oh, what's the other one? The one I do not like. Oh, Stadium Bravo.
Oh, God. Stadium Bravo so much. Coastline's okay for me. I'm not the most aggressive player in the world, so it's not one I enjoy.
Defending is very difficult.
Yeah, defending is difficult. For sure.
I played it today, and
fortunately, we don't need to worry about either of those maps here because it's not being played.
Yes, very true.
Oh,
that's an interesting trade card.
Kind of bait it out.
I guess the rule. That is a very interesting and useful information. No, I don't think that's getting cleared. You need EMPs for that one. No, they don't have EMPs. I think this is going to be a strat like they did in the first round from K9.
Oh, yeah.
I'm setting up for it. It's just going to be a different style by the looks of things. Because the Glaz and the Monty, they're just going to plant in some smoke and Glaz is going to cover, I think is the idea on the door.
A little bit more anger.
And they don't have any, they only have Cade C4. This is all on Cade to stop this execute. That C4 of his, that's going to count me vital. Ah well, that's just probably the push shot down with that kill.
There we go, that's not very good.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that was an angle.
It was a very nice little angle in the fountain, looking down.
Oh, that was unfortunate timing. Good kill from Trunk. I mean, you have to feel that they got quite lucky with that kill on. Tebs got killed onto him. What's that one, T? Pretty sure that was a wall bag. I think Spirit is going to go for something special with that Han Solo's blaster.
Yeah, it really does remind you of the Han Solo.
It really does.
I don't trust myself with that big of a scope. Don't know what I'm shooting, unless it's on Mars.
Well, I have to wonder what Monty was doing now after seeing him pick up the diffuser outside of the map. Monty went for the plug and the diffuser.
I didn't know you could see the stairs from there.
Wow, that is a good angle.
But I'm learning all these angles today.
Yeah, exactly. We are learning a lot.
Go, I'm going to go play border after this.
Yeah.
That's great. So I got that one. I got the jackal sitting on top of the table.
Yeah.
I have to wear a helmet if I'm playing this next time. They're going to be peeking me.
You're going to need to. These are angles you need to hit your shots, though.
That's very true. And I do that rarely.
Yeah, but you also need to react quickly. And with your new monitor, you can do that.
Ah, look at that. 240 frames. I can see space. I can see the dust that flies off the carpet. Yeah. But it is quite different. And to be fair, my playing has gone up ridiculously from 60 to 240.
You're playing?
Yeah, my just general
reaction. Between playing, what, you've been playing the game more since you're getting it?
I was playing better.
Ah, yes. Yeah, that's what I've found when I've increased my FPS.
Yeah. So I'm just trying to, also, I've got a piece that can run it. I'm currently playing
on an Xbox One, it's rough, 60 FPS.
Oh yeah.
Painful.
Everyone's at the same level though.
No.
No?
I think some people have 144 frames with the new gen consoles. With the new gen consoles you can run it. But a lot of people don't realise that they need to have a monitor they can run it. So like I have a lot of friends, they have the new generation but they don't have the frames because they haven't invested in a monitor. Talking of which, I have a friend who made the same mistake as you, Andrew.
It's a common mistake.
He had a £2,000 PC with a 60Hz monitor.
Couldn't be me. Could never be me. Definitely.
Well, at least your mistake was fixed.
Yes, because everyone told me it was wrong. I'm happy they did though, because I would have never known. I was like, oh, why is this great PC not making anything run better?
Yeah, why is it making me play better? Oh.
Yeah, why can't I play better with all this money I spend? Boys, it's only skins make me play better.
Yeah, definitely not pay to win, boys.
Gotta love PC gaming, pay to win.
All the peripherals make it better.
Yeah, Logitech, gotta plug them. Is this Logitech? Yeah, this is Logitech, boys.
Oh, you're Logitech, I'm a SteelSeries, I've got everything SteelSeries.
Yeah, it's disgusting. I've tried your headset and it feels like, it's disgusting. It's terrible, oh, I hate it so much.
It's wireless though.
Yeah, I have a SteelSeries headset as well, it's terrible, I hate it. Yes, I can do that with my Logitech headset. Do you see any wires here?
I have to rep the, Destiny mouse I got, limited edition.
And I have to rep the Superlight. Best mouse you're gonna ever see.
I see no RGB though. Where's the RGB?
RGB is for children.
Can't relate. Definitely don't have every single thing as RGB on my my counter right now. I got RGB keyboard with the mouse. Anyway, back to the game.
Yeah,
we've got ourselves.
We haven't seen much so far, to be fair. They've not given us much. They're just pushing the top floor out, clearing it out very slowly.
They're stopping the rush. They've got the
castle's stopped. Castle has to fight his way out. And he's that's a good start.
Got it. He's just better.
No, that's good. Oh, that was nice with DJ. He realised that the Temps was going to move, so he just threw the nade, pushed him into the fight. The fight was on his Temps.
Someone downstairs now this time. Because last time we did, that worked. From the
good from the Yana. Important that he cleared that out. Well, that's not what you want to see. I don't think the angle exists that he's looking for, to be honest.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he's trying to look into. Oh,
that was a nice
dodge, anyway.
That's a nice angle, man.
And he's finished.
That's the game. I think we're just going to go to a quick, like, 5 minute break between maps. Then we'll start this final map.
I'm ready. Well, that was very riveting. What a riveting game.
So I should just be going to a break any moment now.
Always first to the finish line. First to the plate when it's dinner time. First to the skate when the shit goes down and these motherfucking clowns to the finish line. Always first to the finish line. First to the plate when it's dinner time. First to the skate when the shit goes down and these motherfucking clowns to the finish line.
Hello boys, I'm back.
Good day. Hello, hello.
We're back.
We are back.
For real this time. Yeah, I don't know why, but some idiot said, boys, I'm back. That was really weird. I don't know who said that.
Crazy. Anyway.
Yeah, looking forward to this game on Cafe once we are able to see it.
That's Cafe. Okay.
Yeah.
I'm hoping for some more angles. I'm ready to learn today.
I don't play much Portal because I don't know the map, but Cafe, now that's a good map I would use angles on.
It's the only map I use mirror on. Only map.
Oh, I remember that.
Some good mirror spaces. It has helped me a few times. But there is quite a few ways to kill it. Anyway, we're going to see some bans. What are you thinking? Target bans?
I don't think that's changed too much, to be honest, with the bans. I think we'll see pretty much the same as we have seen. So far,
I'm thinking.
So, like a No Kazami, Ying, Warden, that type of thing, you know?
Yeah, well, we got the Jackal. That's just been banned in defense.
Yeah.
I'm thinking, let's do a. I'm sorry, I'm going to say a Nook. I'm going to guess. Oh. And it is.
There's
a Nook. There we go. Look at that. I am just.
Powerful. Son.
No. Just no.
Alright, what do you think this time? They did Falk on the first map, and they did Warden. Yeah, I'm gonna go Warden. I think Warden.
and maybe we delayed Arthur's army. They did it.
They chose to do his army instead of no. It was Elbow that banned his army the previous two times. Worf said, "All right, enough's enough. We're doing it. Let's see what you're gonna ban."
They've got something against his army.
Oh, they banned Solas. I like that ban.
Solas. Okay. That's very, very, very interesting.
Yeah, clearly Elbow didn't want to deal with any more jackal. They must have found that quite annoying, especially on the first map.
Yeah,
TJ's still here though. I'm looking forward to hearing this.
It stops people like Dokkaebi playing, because
they should have banned Capcan, I feel. Yeah, the TJ and Capcan just too powerful.
Especially on Cafe, a lot of doors.
Yeah. Always. Exactly. I mean, he's not picking it yet, but I imagine he'll pick it at some point.
Yeah, especially in last minute plays, Capcan's very good. Everyone's running about, not checking doors.
Do you enjoy playing this map?
I don't mind it. I would rather. This is like top five.
It's decent.
Top five. Below.
What do you think is the most underrated map?
Oh, labs. 100%.
Oh yeah, for sure. I think that's a very good shot. I think it's a great map.
Like
for me, the most underrated map is Canal.
Yeah.
Canal's a very, very good map in my opinion. It's in my top three for sure, if not top
really?
One.
Really? Top three?
Yeah. Maybe even top one. It's an amazing map.
Not bad. It's,
I think it's so underrated.
Like for attacking side, it's a bit difficult. For defense,
it's great. I disagree. I think it's just amazing.
Fair
I think it's great to attack and great to defend.
Work on playstyle. I'm more of a wait for them to come to me type guy.
Oh, so am I.
Oh yeah, well.
That's what I do on defense anyway.
Yeah. Well. Yeah, I find labs though. A lot of people don't
labs
like it.
Labs is really good.
If you haven't played it, you don't like it. If you did that event they had where they had extra credit just for you to play the game, that's when you like it. Because I remember grinding out.
I thought that was for Emerald Plates.
It was. You're right. But they did it so you couldn't ban it, wasn't it?
Yeah, they stopped you from banning that.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that was really good because that was like.
Yeah, exactly. I'm going to enjoy it. I believe when the map first came out, I was 9-0. So it was something crazy like that. 9 wins, 0 losses. Yeah.
Wow. Well, yeah, you're just better. You're smarter.
Yeah. We don't talk about Emerald Plains, so.
No, Emerald Plains. I don't like Emerald Plains.
No one likes Emerald Plains.
Well, that's because I feel like I would like it if they did that thing.
I think it's just a bad map, unfortunately.
It's in theory it should be good. It's got 3 sets of staircases, a lot of place rotations, it's got a lot of rooms.
3 sets of staircases I don't think are too important.
Well, I think it helps for like rotations and things
yeah,
like
but
that.
If you look at Clubhouse, that only has 2 staircases and that's one of the most favourite maps.
Cafe or
Coastline only has 2 maps as staircases as well. Ward only has 2 staircases.
Well,
yeah, but people like Coastline, people like Ward.
No, he's not. I thought.
Oh,
no,
did
no,
you
go.
Get instant C4? I don't even know where that went.
I did. I think it was just. Oh, I didn't even know he was.
Oh, that's
yeah,
C4.
Oh,
yeah,
right, okay.
That was nice. That's nice.
Very nice.
Do they have any intel in there? They don't have. Maybe
they
a Mozzie camp?
Like sound.
Surely.
At least.
It, yeah. Well, either a Mozzie camp. Good trade from Terps, though. Very important for sure. Means that they could be confident that the rest of the players on site.
Well, we got some interesting angle watching. No one is there, but little does he know. To flush him out.
Yeah, now he knows that it's been covered, so he needs to be careful. Very isolated though. So this feels like it could, if Elbow were to realise this, it could be a 2v1, but and then another 2v1.
They are playing very spread out.
It's a passive setup, there's not too much time left. But it looks like they are grouping. DJ's going for crazy play here. He's getting punished. They were able to get together just in time to stop that play.
Interesting 50-50s make right now.
15 seconds remaining.
I mean, I like where he's playing. Oh.
10 seconds left.
That was unfortunate for lazy clear. Oh, what a shot from both! Oh my god! Tevz, he lost the 1v1. Every day you see that.
I thought he was going to get killed. I don't know. But then both going on each door, in theory, they should have seen.
They should have known where he was. They just didn't have the time to find out where he was. Just unfortunate for Mzonkin, but he needs to be able to see him there.
Say he had another player on his team, which was time.
Yeah, he did. I mean, it's quite surprising to see Tebs not win a 1v1.
Oh.
Especially in a fashion like that, Bo maybe is just better.
He's many bombs better. As I say.
Bomb located by attackers.
Oh, we got a kitchen there. Okay. Pretty usual locations. Always top floor, then the very bottom, and then they're probably going to go.
Yeah.
Library.
I think kitchen is the best site of the map, to be honest, or the easiest to play and win. But I think top floor is the site that you see people most. If you look at the highest level of competition, though, the teams are often playing like mining and raiding first. They seem to like these sites, but I think that's just down to them. So, how long can they speed? Yeah, exactly. I think that's the idea.
We're planning Vader to go either top or bottom.
I find even with attacker repick in ranked at least, you can pick a weird site and they won't be ready for it. They'll have picked completely wrong ops. Caught off guard because most people are dead AFK and their folks. They're in third base. A lot of the time anyway. Spraying wall. That wall's very dead down.
They're watching for anyone peeking in that garage.
I'm very scared. Not sure why I need the ball. I seem very sure that someone is close, but there's nothing here. I want scared of ghosts.
I don't know if I saw a ghost, I'll be shooting at it too. Anyway,
this would be great for a cap cam.
I think you missed the ghost, truthfully, if you were shooting there.
I wouldn't hit the head.
I did not know.
All about intel.
Bob could just play it safe now, but he wants more. He's not had enough. He's thirsty for more. Feed the beast.
He's going to come down the other stairs. Let's see if he can pick anything up.
What do you feel about the exchange round on the T5? That's not something I've seen before. You're an avid Legion player.
What was that?
I know you being an avid Legion player. How do you feel about
it? I am.
Extended barrel on the T5.
Oh, I use that all the time. All the time. That's what I use. It's great. I mean, it's just extra damage. Every time you can pick up extra damage. As long as you can control the recoil. Which,
me personally, I prefer just trying to hit the head. That's why I normally just go for something like flash and
yeah, I can't trust myself when it comes to head cops. So whatever gives me the extra damage.
At least at the ranks I play, you need to be hitting headshots if you want to perform. If you're not hitting headshots, what are you doing?
Down here in Plaids, it's hard life. Body shots and legs.
I mean, you can certainly get to the higher ranks playing like that, but if you want to perform really well, you need to be hitting those headshots all the time.
True. I mean, I've got the crosshair placement kind of down. It's just, I get caught out a lot. Attackers running about.
That's your face now.
It is, I run about, even on defense. Left, right, up and down. Oh, was he getting killed here?
Nice scuffed kill. But yeah, that very nice double for Brock.
Right, okay, well, there we go. He's just better.
And we see an excellent clear from Bob. Very nice flank. He saw couches.
It's a very, very intense game, although Wolf needs to take off some rounds. Sure, they'll have some tricks up their sleeves, we hope.
Yeah, you'd have to imagine. I mean, woof, they've really been shut down ever since DJ's been here. I know as well that DJ, he's a very vocal. He likes to organize his players as well. I have to wonder if they were really lacking that in the first map. Because it's been very clean for my boy so far.
Yeah, maybe DJ's
been too ready. Some cap now from DJ there.
Oh, there we go. I'm ready for these trip mine plays and the moddy.
Yeah, I mean, the first round he played it, he got the triple kill with cap gun. I wonder if he could find that kind of impact again. Just having up the drones, I think, at the moment.
Doesn't look like they're going for a very quick push, but they are on Ash and Havana. They could always switch it up. Oh, they got the ace, Still the Iron, the Ash, Ace, it's always good to... Although, no, it's hard to... They are mid-floor, they could do a rush if they wanted. They'll be careful with the cap cans at their little toes. way. That is a prime spot for spawn peaks and jump outs. Many times I've been killed on that highway.
I loved running out people over here as well. I recently came up with a strategy of just having a tar spike go down the white stairs window and hitting it 8 times. So they think they're safe, but they're not.
Very smart. Very smart. This is actually, I don't know, I'm always around that end trying to throw nades up to that top window and everyone jumps out and
it's been frustrating though because I normally play around the white stairs and my cocktail player just keeps dying to open the wire and flinging through heaven. And we lose the round.
Can't trust the randoms.
Really can't.
So it's proper gambling, these randoms. Sometimes they're pros, sometimes they look like they're new to the game.
Most of the time it's bad.
Most times it's bad, yeah. Can't lie, I've been that random.
So I have as well, I think we all have.
Oh, they're gonna do a hot drop. Looking at the angles, check where they are. They may have not heard the drop. They're not checking the angle yet. One is opening up that.
I don't know where this top floor room is yet. He may have just dropped though. But I don't know, he's still up there, babe. Where's the fight? It's drunk.
Well, he might run into.
Get there eventually.
No. On the opposite side from them, so hopefully they don't turn.
Could have been a good pick here to deal with this cap again. This is another kill from DJ. DJ gets his first kill of Cap Cad, because of course he does. Oh, Fong's in the next mission here, they don't know he's here. Very nice double.
Oh, what a bloody play, that was very good.
They didn't join him, they didn't know. That's not the first time I've said that this time, this Marvel either. They've just been, it's like they haven't been joining.
They even had Diana as well, for just a quick run around the corner if they needed to.
But they've been caught out too many times in situations like this where they just don't know.
Silly goose.
The intel game is just not there. They're getting destroyed in regards to that and endgame.
Very well. They've got to really pull it back now, hoping for a. Who's a team that does good pullbacks? I know G2 do a good few pullbacks.
Yeah, G2 did a full low bracket one at SI, so they are certainly good at it.
Let's do a fat pullback, I believe. Protect your bombs from being enhance their inner G2s.
I don't think they're quite chip on G2's level, to be completely honest with you.
You sure about that? Or don't they have a 5v3?
No one's on G2's level. No. They may have lost the major, but they lost the team they destroyed. They lost not because the other team was good, but because they were playing bad.
They lost out of pity.
Exactly.
They just had to give them
some. They just wanted Liquid to just go and choke again. They wanted to watch that more than win.
They gave them encouragement, yeah. Cover the location of a bomb.
10 seconds left. You're gonna maybe so. I thought we'd maybe gonna see Spawn P there, but maybe not.
5 seconds left. Pixel. It's pretty normal. We need nothing to help cover it, but oh, this. I think they're gonna be going straight through Skylight here with the operators they have on Elbow's side. The Monty is just gonna be dropping inside of the smoke thrown by the Candelas everywhere, and Glazor will just be providing over covering fire. Anyone who tries to walk up. God.
I'm not sure how much control upstairs they have right now.
Yeah, but by the looks of things, they're not set up for this kind of thing. They're going to have a player in Pixel, probably going to have a Roman. There's probably going to only be one person to get close to contest this if they're quick. I think they're probably going to do some droning first, though, just to double check, see what's happening around the map.
Yeah, they do have two C4s in pocket, where on this site, there are quite a lot of places to get C4 from, especially if you're putting down a farm.
You've got to keep your eyes on this Warden. This Warden is pivotal for this round. He counters this entire strategy.
So they're throwing nades in, they're throwing explosions. Oh dear.
And that's the Warden. That's right, the Warden.
Well, the Warden's clutch.
That's the strategy over. Yeah, that's the strategy over.
That round. They're gonna try and pull it back, but they gotta be a bit careful.
Yeah, it's a rough position to go from here. Neither their gadgets, both their gadgets are now redundant. Now that, you know, that Warden's on the board. They just gotta try and shoot them.
He's throwing most of their candelas down as well, so.
Yeah, when it comes to their guns, on the attacking side, they're not the greatest. At the end of the day, though, all you need to do is hit the head.
True. As long as they let hit your head first. C4 but misses. That is a shame. Shoots that C4. He didn't even detonate.
Yeah, Bob really enjoying that magazine size right now.
Yeah, yes,
it's a quick reload as well with that energy. He's been pinned in here. He's trying to bind the wheel hatch. Yeah, lads. Easy kill for him. Easy pick up. Good communication from the two of them.
There you go. They've put the borders even now. And that one's in. This is very possible.
It is. Borders are still alive, so they still can't use their gadgets though. Not that they have anything there. They still only have a couple of smokes. The Glaz.
The Glaz is
better than Warden and looking for smokes, but it's still not easy. Oh, that was big damage from the Bow. Have to wonder if he's going to ruin the opportunity or failing to get that kill. They know that they're both in sight now, though. They drew, the picture was clear. They're just going to check to see where they are, and they're probably going to know they're both cocked up. It's only 20 seconds left though, running out of time. Then he really needs to speed this up and get these picks. Bob's in a really good position right now, but they don't have the fuse on. They're still going from the skyline. They have no time, they need to get into him right now. And Bob missed that shot. He's fully round over. He needs to take that shot, especially with him being so low, but good close. Yeah, that kill on the 1-2 was pivotal. It was a nice attempt at the comeback, but it was just too much.
Well, there we go. Match point. Let's see what goes. Still hoping for that G2 pullback.
Yeah, I mean they're on for it now. They've won the first round.
They're on the way. They're on the way.
Once you could say that's the hardest round to win the first.
And it also it gives you a little bit of hope in the heart. Fight the rest of the round. They got the similar picks for the work for the last round. Why not do it again?
Yeah, exactly. But DJ's team, they're taking it slow now. They're going for the default, picking up the normal operators. We do expect to see. Not seen too much from DJ so far. Just got the one kill on the cap can. But I have no doubt he'll be able to pull off this round. I do have to wonder if they can be contesting Bakery, because I imagine that's going to be the kind of pressure we'll see from Melbourne.
Right. Attackers doing a nice. Oh, they're on. I was going to say they're a good setup downstairs, but they are downstairs. I just wasn't paying attention. Right. I'm reloading. Take out all the defaults before they see what they are. Probably very hidden about it.
No, I don't think so. It's just they're being diligent so far. Doing checking all the boxes in the checklist. They feel like a very good check this team. They're very slow, diligent. That isn't very diligent. Oh, he's lucky to get away with his life there. That was slightly brave, Bob, maybe feeling himself a bit too concerned.
They're being a bit too aggressive on the peaks right there, especially on that type of angle from very
excellent
far away.
Excellent entry from DJ, and what did I say?
Sending Gemini!
There you go, checking the corners, there we go. Not going to fall for another round situation.
I don't know if you knew this, Andrew, but if you sprint while looking at the ceiling, you run 10 times faster. You can clearly see that. Yeah, I didn't know that then. Should have been looking at the ceiling, sprinting for purposes, clear out. Oh,
right.
Yeah. There's about a high level strat that not many people know about.
That 100 IQ per player.
Oh, another kill from DJ. He's on for the triple. Take the round. I told you to keep your eyes on DJ that round, and he popped up with a double entry. Been well done from Melbourne. Well, that's them winning the semi-finals, and they'll be up against the winner of the next game.
Well done. Good play. Anyway.
So, any final thoughts about that game?
I think it was quite cool. It was very fun to see. I was liking the. I keep going on about the angles, but I'm loving the angles that they had.
Yeah, especially on that border.
Yeah, the border is my favorite round with the border. Don't know about you. Out of the three, what was your favorite?
None were my favorite. None. They were all very
good.
They were
all bad.
They were all very good. Very enjoyable to watch.
All right, well, I liked it. I liked the plays, some good kills, some silly deaths.
It's quite remarkable to see that the difference from Elbora once they got DJ in.
Yeah.
Very remarkable.
Obviously the IG.
They were so much worse in that first get map. Then once they got DJ in, it wasn't close.
True.
4-2-4-1.
Maybe they should have just brought him in quicker. Feel bad.
Maybe DJ is the secret carry.
The secret carry. Maybe it's the
real MVP.
I know. Very, very fun. Very good. So who do you know who they'll be against next?
Well, we need to play the second game first.
Oh.
Find that out.
Well, very, very excited for that one.
I think that's us done now.
Boom.
Well, thanks for watching.
Yay. See you next time. If I'm here.
Always first to the finish line. First to the plate when it's dinner time. First to the skate when this shit goes down. And these motherfucking clowns to the finish line. Always first to the finish line. First to the plate when it's dinner time. First to the skate when this shit goes down. And these motherfucking clowns to the finish line. Always.